أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون.
We used to fast the same days as the Jews. Ayat came down. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام. Those of you who have iman, fasting has been made mandatory upon you. Okay? كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم. Just like it was made mandatory upon the people who came much before you. Who are those people who had fasting as a fard on them? The Jews. Banu Israel, the Israelites. The Sharia of Musa alayhi salam. So even Allah is saying part of your identity is the same as the identity of the Jews. But in the same surah, already He separated us from them by separating our Kaaba. He separated them. But now He's saying we have something in common with them, which is what? Fasting. Fasting is the same between us and them. Then He says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So that you can have taqwa. You people can have taqwa. Now it's interesting that in the first half of Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah talked about who again? If you were paying attention, who does Allah talk about? The Jews. And Allah complains the entire time, why don't you have taqwa? The entire time the problem is they have no taqwa. And now Allah says, you are given the same exercise as them. Which is what? Fasting. And what's the point of all of it? So you can have taqwa. Now the same thing happens with fasting. Fasting, you're constantly feeling something, aren't you? Especially in Qatar. Especially in the Khalij. You're constantly feeling thirst. You're constantly feeling hunger. There is not a minute that goes by that you're not feeling it. Your throat is fighting with you. Your lungs are fighting with you. Your throat is yelling at you and saying, give me water, give me water, give me water. Whether you like it or not, your throat is begging you. And you tell your throat, shut up, throat. It's not Maghrib yet. Your stomach starts talking to you, sometimes very loudly. Hey man, come on, what's going on up there? Where's the supply, you know? And you're like, it's Fajr, dude. You're starting already, you know? You have a conversation with yourself. But you know what? There's a war going on inside you when you're fasting. There's a war, physical war going on inside you. Your throat is against you. Your stomach is against you. Your body is getting weaker and begging you, please disobey Allah. Please disobey Allah. And you stay the entire day fasting, fighting your body, and you say, no, my heart is submitted to Allah, and therefore I don't care if my entire body wants something, I will not give it to it. You train your heart to control your body. That's what you do when you fast. That's what I do when I fast. Why is that important? Because when the fasting is over, you have to continue to train your, now your heart is ready to control your body. So you're not just gonna eat what you want. You're not just gonna go where you want. You're not just gonna look at what you want. Because all of those things your body wants. But who has gotten stronger when you fast? The body got weaker and who got stronger? The heart got stronger. And where does taqwa rest? إِنَّ ذَلِكَ مِن تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. The heart is the place of taqwa. When you give your body the weakness and you give your heart the strength, you train yourself to stop yourself from other things. Even if you, when you think of Ramadan, the first thing you think of is fasting. If you don't think of the food, at least you think of fasting. Or you say, man, Ramadan this year is coming in the summer. Oh, it's gonna be hard. That's the thought that goes in your head. Allah says in the Quran, the first thing you should think about when you hear the word Ramadan, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Not الذي كتب فيه الصيام. الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month in which Quran came down. Ramadan, the month in which the Quran came down. The thing that makes Ramadan special is not the fasting. The thing that makes Ramadan special is the Quran. That is Allah telling us. That is Allah telling us. Now you have to ask yourself, if you are fasting in Ramadan, but you don't recite any Quran. You're fasting in Ramadan, but you didn't memorize not even one page, the whole 30 days. Not even half a page, not even two ayahs. You didn't memorize anything in Quran, from the Quran. Then how do you understand what Allah is saying? The entire purpose of Ramadan is to celebrate the Quran. I told you. Our constitution is celebrated. It was revealed in the month of Ramadan. Allah didn't give us one day to celebrate. He gave us 30 days to celebrate the coming of the Quran. This is the month of Ramadan is the celebration of the fact that Allah made us an ummah. Now we have our own capital and we have our own constitution and we have our own days of fasting. No longer the same as the days of the Jews. No more ayyam al-ma'dudat. Now it's Shahr Ramadan. They did not have Shahr Ramadan. So Allah made this guidance for all people. You know what that means? He made all human beings equal. Just by Quran, by the institution of Salat. We cannot be racist because we have Salat. We cannot be supremacist. We cannot think my nation is better than your nation. My nationality is better than your nationality. My language is better than your language. My skin color is better than your skin color. My village is better than your village. We can't do it. And you know when we are reminded that we can't do that? When we stand together in Salat. When Bilal radiallahu anhu is standing next to Uthman radiallahu anhu, we are reminded that we're equal. This is Hudan Linnas. That's what that means. You know why I'm highlighting that? Because I notice it in Muslims. I notice asabiya in Muslims. I notice Muslims make fun of other nationalities, look down on them, talk bad about them, talk bad about people that speak a different language. The Arabi makes fun of the non-Arabi. The Bangladeshi makes fun of the Pakistani. The Pakistani makes fun of the Indian. The Filipino makes fun of the Malaysian. What's going on here? Don't we make salat? Don't we make salat? Because if we're not learning from our salat, if we're not learning from this Quran, then we're just, it's like I tell you, we're just a shell. You know, if you have a shell and you don't have any egg inside, that's what our Islam is sometimes. It's just you look like Muslim, you say the words that Muslims say, but inside your heart, there's no love for your deen. Every one of us here that are sitting in this audience, so many different countries are sitting in this audience right now. It's such an international gathering right here. This is a United Nations meeting right now. You know? Let me tell you, I don't know your name. Some of you know my name. I don't know your name. But you know what? We have a relationship with each other that is thicker than blood. It is thicker than blood just because of La ilaha illallah. Just because of that, for guidance. This ayah was supposed to be about Ramadan. لِأَنَّهَا بَدَأَتْ بِكَلِمَةْ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ. The ayah began with شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ. But so far he says Quran came down in it. It's a guidance for people. It's got multiple proofs from the guidance, meaning the guidance itself has miracles that if you look at them, you will know this can only be the word of Allah. بَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَىٰ وَالْفُرْقَانِ. And it distinguishes between right and wrong. All of this up until now, Allah didn't say anything about Ramadan. What's He only talking about? Quran. More than half this ayah is about Quran. Why is He doing that? Because He wants to make sure no Muslim ever forgets that Ramadan is about the Quran. Ramadan is about the Quran. It's about the miracle of this book.